Good morning. We have already solved this problem, and we need to work with unit vectors and projectile motion. So let's solve it again, only this time using unit vectors.
Flippin' physics!
Bobby, please read the problem, and Bo, please tell me everything we know in terms of unit vectors.
Hold up, Mr. P. That sounds exactly like the last problem we did.
It's not the same.
It's very similar.
But it's not the same.
Close enough.
Y'all did that last time. Do you really not learn?
Do you not get a joke?
I guess not.
Yeah, so this is actually the fourth lesson to use the Nerd-A-Pult, and just like the second lesson, this fourth lesson solves the same problem as the lesson before it, only we are using unit vectors. Bobby and Bo, please.
A ball is launched from the Nerd-A-Pult with an initial speed of 3.25 meters per second at an angle of 61.7 degrees above the horizontal. If the basket is 8.7 centimeters above the ball vertically, where should the basket be placed horizontally relative to the ball so the ball lands in the basket?
Okay, so I get it this time.
We know the initial and final position vectors, the initial velocity vector, and the acceleration vector. Let's set the initial point at zero, so our position naught equals zero times unit vector I plus zero times unit vector j meters. The final position of the ball is 8.7 centimeters or 0.087 meters in the y direction, and an unknown distance, let's call it x, in the x direction. So final R position equals X times I plus 0.087 times J meters. The initial velocity is exactly the same as the last time we did this problem. We need the initial velocity components in the X and Y directions, which works out to be, again, exactly the same as last time when we used unit vectors. The acceleration of any object in projectile motion is 9.81 meters per second squared in the negative y direction, and it has no acceleration in the x direction, so 0 times I plus negative 9.81 times j meters per second squared.
Thank you, Bo. Billy, please begin solving the problem.
Absolutely. Like before, let's use the uniformly accelerated motion equation. R position equals R naught plus velocity naught times time plus 1/2 acceleration times time squared. Substitute all those unit vector equations into that equation, remove the zeros, multiply through by time, and multiply through by time squared. Let's isolate the x direction terms, and we get all the terms that have unit vector I in them, so that is x equals 1.54079 times time. Okay, so we have two unknowns, so we cannot do anything with this equation right now. Let's put that in our equation holster.
Equation holster.
Okay, let's switch over to the y direction and all the j unit vector terms. We get 0.087 equals 2.86155 times time minus 4.905 times time squared. Oh boy, there's only one unknown. However, we are going to have to use the quadratic formula. I'm not good with the quadratic formula.
Thanks, Billy. Yes, we are going to need to use the quadratic formula. And yes, believe it or not, students tend to struggle when using the quadratic formula. So here is my requirement. Whenever we use the quadratic formula, we have to actually write out the equation every time.
Every time?
Every time.
Every time.
Nah.
Bo, please give it a whirl. Solve for time in this equation.
Sure. Start by subtracting 0.087 from both sides and rearrange the equation from largest to smallest exponent. The quadratic formula is, because we have to write it out every time, negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all
over 2a. Just a second, Bo. It is called the quadratic formula, not the quadratic expression. Therefore, something equals this. What is this equal to?
Okay. Time. Time is the unknown in the quadratic equation. Therefore, the quadratic formula solves for time.
So time equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c, all divided by the quantity 2 times a. The numbers in front of the variables are...
The coefficients.
Thanks.
The numbers in front of the variables are called coefficients.
Right. Thanks. The coefficients are, well, A is negative 4.905, B is 2.86155, and C is negative 0.087. So it works out to be negative 2.86155 plus or minus 2.54588, all divided by negative 9.81. Time then equals 0.291697 plus or minus 0.259519, which equals 0.551216 or 0.0321784 seconds. The quadratic formula gives us two real solutions for time, but how do we know which one is correct?
Thanks, Bo. In a bit, I will explain how we know it is the larger of the two times. For now, let's finish the problem using that larger time. Bobby, please?
Okay. Well, we go back to the equation holster, to the x direction or I unit vector equation, and substitute that larger time in. So, x equals 1.54079 times 0.551216, and that equals 0.849308 meters, or 85 centimeters with 2 sig figs. That means the basket needs to be placed 85 centimeters horizontally from the initial x position of the ball, just like what we got last time. Yep, the physics still works.
Cool.
Y'all really do like redundancy.
Very nice, Bobby. All right, let's talk a little bit more about all the useful information we can glean from using the quadratic formula. First off, remember that the quadratic equation is an equation which describes a parabola. This parabola describes the position of the ball as a function of time. And the quadratic formula gave us this equation for time. In other words, the time to the top of the parabola is 0.291697, or 0.29 seconds. This is the time at which the ball reaches its maximum height. 0.259519, or 0.26 seconds, is how long after the ball reaches its maximum height that the ball reaches a height of 0.087 meters. 0.259519, or 0.26 seconds, is also how long before the ball reaches its maximum height that the ball reaches a height of 0.087 meters. So you can see, the ball is at a height of 0.087 meters twice after launch. Once, 0.032178.4, or 0.032 seconds after launch while the ball is going up, and once 0.551216, or 0.55 seconds after launch while the ball is going down. In order for the ball to land in the basket, the ball must be moving down. Therefore, it must be the larger of the two times, the second time the ball is at a height of 0.087 meters, and the ball is moving downward, that it reaches the basket. That is how we know the time to use is 0.551216 seconds. Hopefully, you now recognize how useful the quadratic formula can be, and you remember that you must write down the quadratic formula every time you use it.
Every time.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Yep, y'all do love your redundancy.